reception. So this is your maths lesson for Wednesday, the 25th of March. Well done for all your super learning so far. I'm sure you're all doing a really good job at home, and I hope that you're all working hard and also being kind to one another, because I know what it's like when you are stuck at home. Everyone can feel a bit frustrated, but hopefully these lessons will give you a chance to focus on something else and to relax and enjoy. So we're going to get started today with practicing our subitizing. Now, subitizing is when you can just recognize a number without having to count. So whether that's recognizing the value of a number of dots on a dice or on your fingers. And we're going to practice today by using our cowboy fingers, okay? So I'm going to hide my hand behind my back, and I'm going to say a number, and I want you to show me that number on your fingers without having to sort of pause and count, okay? Ready? So, number five. Super, that was an easy one, wasn't it? Okay, hide your hand. Number three. Super, hide your hand. Number two. Super. This time, I wonder whether we could do it with two hands, if you could show me how to make the numbers another way. It's a bit tricky. Ready? So, number four. Or maybe you can make four with two hands. Maybe you can make it another way. Super. Ready? Number five. Maybe you can make it with two hands. Ready? Maybe another way. Maybe another way. Number five, isn't it? Well done, super. Okay, so now our maths brains are all warmed up. We are going to go on to our to doing some more number problems, but this time we're going to focus on story problems that plus. Okay, story problems that plus. Show me that plus sign, like a ninja. D. Ha! Super, plus sign. D. Remember when we're adding. Plus, our numbers are getting bigger, we're counting forwards, okay? So, right, I'm going to tell you my first problem. Listen. A student rides 1 mile, then she rides six more. She's got a brand new bike for her birthday. She rides 1 mile, and then she rides six more. So, let's begin to the first part. The student rides 1 mile. So, what do I write for that one? That's right, number one. Fantastic. Then she rides six more miles. So there's the word more there. That tells me that what do I need to write next? Plus six. Well done. So I'm going to ride six, or she's going to ride six more miles. Fantastic. Now I want to find out what one plus six equals, so I mustn't forget my equals sign. Now, remember, when I see plus six, what do I need to do? That's right, I need to write six lines. I need to draw six lines. So I'm going to draw six lines here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which number do I need to get going? The number one. Fantastic, Liddy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1 plus 6 equals 7. Super. That's number 7. That's my first plus problem solved. Okay, I'm going to rub that one out. Now listen to the next one. Ready? Okay. We're going to find out how many miles a teacher drives their car. Okay. So, the teacher drives 9 miles and then he drives 5 more. Listen again. First, the teacher drives 9 miles. So what do I write for that one? That's right, I start with a 9. And then he drives 5 more. So I've heard that word more, so I know this is a plus problem. So I need to write plus 5 because he drives 5 more. Now, what do I need to do next? I want to find out how much this equals. So So yeah, that's right. I mustn't forget to write my equals sign. So okay, what do I need to do to find out how much this equals? So I've got plus 5. So I need to make how many lines? Plus, absolutely. So I'm going plus 5. Well done. So I need to write 5 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Which number do I need to get going? That's right, number 9. So I'm going to start with 9. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. How many altogether? 14. 14 is a teen number. I know that teen numbers always start with a 1. 14 is a 1 and a 4. 9 plus 5 equals 14. Super. Right, I've got one more that I'm going to give you now. Ready? So, okay, ready? A teacher drives 10 miles. They drive 10 miles and then they drive 7 more. Listen again. A teacher drives 10 miles, then he drives 7 more. So, which number do I need to start with? A teacher drives 10 miles. That's right, I need to start with number 10. And then he drives 7 more. So I need to do a plus 7. Now, I've got 7 lines. I've got plus 7, so I need to draw 7 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so I know I need to start with the number 10, so I'm going to get 10 going. Ready? 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Silly me, silly, what have I forgotten? Of course, if you're doing this along at home with me, I'm sure you'll have already done it. I need to write my equals sign. And now I've forgotten what it equals, so I'm just going to count again. That's okay. So, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17. So it's another teen number, so it starts with a 1. That's right. So 17 is a 1 and a 7. 10 plus 7 equals 17. Super. Well done. Now, I've got some challenges for you to do at home. Now, the first challenge is to open your counting books. Turn to page 5. And in these activities, you've got to draw 5 kites. So, I'm going to let you choose which shapes you want to draw the kites. Hopefully you will be able to choose some of the shapes that we've already learnt. You know, the triangle, the square, the oblong, and the circle. This one's actually started with a square that's been turned on its side, so it looks like a diamond, but it's still called a square. And then, as it says to draw 5 of them, I'd like you to write the number, when you're colouring them in, I'd like you to write the number 5 in the middle, so you can practice writing number 5. Remember, when you write number 5, it has a hat, a back, and a belly. Do it nice and neatly. Then, it says the twins are 5 today, so to draw 5 to draw 5 candles on each cake. Now, once you've done that, I'd like to see if you can write a number sentence to match that picture. What would that number sentence look like? Think about 5 plus 5 equals 8, maybe. And we'll have a look at that when we come back on Thursday. So that's your first challenge. Your first challenge is to go to your counting book and complete the instructions on page 5. Okay? Then, your next challenge is in two parts. So the first thing I'd like you to do is to make your own number line to 20, okay? Now, the way I'd like you to do this is I'd like you to write the numbers, because I'd like you to give yourself a little extra challenge. So write the numbers from 1 to 20 on a piece of paper. Then I'd like you to cut them all up, so they're all in individual numbers. And I'd like you to ask your brother or sister, or mummy or daddy, or cousin, or aunt or uncle, whoever you're living with, to muddle them all up, so they're all in a pickle. Then I'd like you to put them back in the right order. So that's the first part of your challenge, okay? You're going to make your own number line by writing the numbers from 1 to 20. Maybe you might need a bit of help with the team numbers, but I'm sure that your brothers or sisters and mummies and daddies or carers will help you. Write the numbers from 1 to 20, cut them all up so they're all in a big jumble, and then you're going to put them back together. And again, I would really love to see a picture of this. So you can send your pictures to reception.charlesdickens@gmail.com and put number line in the subject line so I can see your lovely work. So that's one of your challenges, is to make a number line from 1 to 20. Okay. Okay, so this is the second part to your number line challenge. Okay. Now, I've written up here a bit of a tricky number problem that I'm going to show you how to use a number line to solve. Okay? So, this is how you do it. You've got your number line, and then you've got your number problem here. So this is 7 plus something equals 11. And this is how you use your number line to solve that problem. So, what am I starting with? Number 7. So I'm going to draw a circle around the number 7, and then I need to find out what's missing from this box. So I'm going to jump forward to 11. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many times did I jump? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 7 plus 4 equals 11. And we can check that using the method that we already know. So if we were to see it written like this, we would write 4 lines, 1, 2, 3, 4. We would get 7 going. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We know that that's right. 7 plus 4 equals 11. I'm just going to do that one more time. Okay, so I'm going to rub this one out. And I'm going to reset my number line. This is quite tricky, so if you're not sure about it, then don't worry, but it's just something for you to have a go at home if you'd like to. Okay, so this time I'm going to go 4 plus what equals 10. So 4 plus something equals 10. So I'm going to start with my number 4. I'm going to draw a circle around it so I know that's where I'm starting. I'm going to jump forward to 10. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many jumps do I do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4 plus 6 equals 10. And again, I can check it. So if I rub the answer out, and I'm treat this like we normally would, I know that I've got 6 lines to make, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I'm going to say 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, that's right, so I know that that's my answer. So that's how you can check it to see if you've got the right answer. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to rub this out and I'm going to write some problems on the board, so that you can freeze the board and you can try and do this at home using your number line in the same way that I've just shown you. Like I said, there's no pressure to do this at all. I know it is a bit tricky. It's just a little bit of a challenge for those that might want it. Okay? So, bear with me while I rub it out and give you some challenges to do. Okay, so I've come down here so that I can tip the camera a little bit. So, you can see that I've got 5 plus something equals 12, 7 plus something equals 15, and 10 plus something equals 13. And I want you to see if you can fill in what those somethings are, and I will give you the answers in Thursday's lesson. So remember, there's no pressure to do this. It's just a bit of a challenge if you would like one at home. But what I would like you all to do is the number line challenge. So write the numbers from 1 to 20, cut them all up, jumble them all up, and put them back together. It's really good practice with being able to kind of have that visual number line in your head, writing your numbers, and also recognising your numbers, particularly your team numbers, and then knowing whether you can put them all back into the right order. Okay, enjoy doing that at home, and I will see you on Thursday. Have a good day. Bye.